Hi friends, I have the honor and pleasure of having with me Dr. Aniket Shenoy. He is ranked 2 MCH neurosurgery exam after MBBS that you give for NIMHANS exam, which is a great achievement. And he has a score of 26.5 out of 30. That was the specialist neurosurgery paper that he has given this year. Awesome rank, awesome score. How are you feeling?
I am feeling very good, sir, right now.
So it must be a great feeling to be able to now join as a new, in the directly into MCH neurosurgery after MBBS.
Yes, sir. Of course, I had this dream since first year itself to join neurosurgery as a branch, and coupled with NIMHANS Institute is just a cherry on the cake to my career ahead, and I'm looking forward to it.
So were you always thinking about neurosurgery?
Yes, sir. Since first year, the day I started studying neuroanatomy, when I saw the brain for the first time in my hand and the arteries over it, I was just mesmerized by how the human brain and nervous system is built. So slowly and gradually, I developed a liking towards nervous system, which I then augmented in second and third year. And then when I came to know that I can pursue neurosurgery as a profession, then I was dedicated to neurosurgery, and then finally I came to know about this NIMHANS Institute. So my target over this period of 2 years was just NIMHANS, and MCS neurosurgery there.
So were you very excited when you saw that DAMS is now offering courses for NIMHANS preparation as well?
Yes, sir. I was in fact looking to join this DAMS course in 2017 itself, as soon as I finished my internship, but I was a bit too late. And then since that day, since last March, I was eagerly waiting for the notification of DAMS so that it comes, and I was the first candidate in my center to join there as well.
Yeah. So how was your experience with the DAMS in NIMHANS course that you
did? It was very good, sir. The best thing DAMS did was it prepares the student to 120% rather than just 100%. So by the time exams arrive, the student is able to recollect all the 100% that he has learned in the over a period of time in the DAMS crash course, sir.
So were you impressed with the quality of teachers that
of
we
course,
had
sir,
for
of course,
different
sir.
Like we had specialized classes for psychiatry, neurology, even for neurosurgery.
We had somebody
from NIMHANS actually coming in to you, and neuroradiology I did myself, and neuropathology. So how was your experience with the teaching faculty?
It was very good, sir. Some things which you never expected, that this concept can be asked like this, or this concept could be learned like this. DAMS teacher gave us that context that yes, this question could be thought about like this, and you should learn this concept in this way as well, might be asked in this exam also. So that is what I liked about DAMS crash course. Rather than giving a very straightforward approach, which most students will do by themselves, they gave a very twisted approach, which was very good, and oriented myself to the exam proper in NIMHANS MCH exam.
So if I put it in a nutshell, that our attempt is to do concept building.
Concept
rather
building,
than
exactly.
Push you towards rote learning.
Rote learning.
So once you do a concept, then what happens is whatever may be the question, you are able to do
able to do it. Yes.
And what was your experience with the, we had specialized study material curated specially for NIMHANS and question bank as well. So what was your experience with both of them?
Question banks are a set of 1,000 questions in psychiatry and more than 700 MCQs. I don't think so. After solving this, it is impossible to not pass NIMHANS exam, provided that one is very diligent and very meticulous in preparing those MCQs, and then again going back to the MCQs which the candidate must have done wrong while solving them.
And I also want to ask you about what was your experience with the mock tests that we had conducted?
Mock tests.
You have before every exam, you have to have some rehearsal.
Yes, sir.
So, what was your experience with the NIMHANS mock test?
The best thing about mock tests is, sir, every candidate gets a benchmark or idea that where he stands as to the main entrance exam. Another best thing about mock test, it is conducted well in advance of the main exam, at least 1 month before. So if a candidate is performing poorly or below his expectations, there is a lot of time to cope up and build up to the main examination day. So two things I liked about mock test is, first of all, it is a concept oriented exam, and secondly, it is conducted well before the main exam. So there is a big buffer zone where I can prepare something which I never studied for the mock test.
And I also want to point out that this is a big difference between way things are being done in a PMT kind of a setup than a PG. So what happens is in like PMT, a lot of people would do a mock test just before the exam.
Exams.
Because you want to see where you are just 5 days before the exam.
Yes, yes.
But when we are dealing with mature kids who are actually doctors right now, and they are looking for super specialty and specialty branches, we want to give them time, so that they can learn from their mistakes.
Yes, exactly.
And that is something that unique that we do in DAMS, that our timings are different from everybody else's.
Exactly.
Because we like to do them a little bit in advance.
Advance.
So that you have time.
Yes.
Because in the end, my goal is not to test you. My goal is to test you, tell you the mistakes, so that you are improving. By the time you give the exam, you improve.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Exactly.
That is the vision. Yes, but I'm so happy that you pointed it out, because usually some people are of the opinion when, you know, some people you look at PMT coachings and all, they say, why DAMS is slightly different?
Yes.
Because we are catering to a different set of people who are actually mature enough to learn from mistakes.
Yes, yes.
So that is the difference.
And it is expected that, sir, DAMS question will not be the straightforward that we usually seen in any other books or something. The point about DAMS mock test is not whether I am scoring less or feeling bad or something. It's just to give you an idea how you need to improve more for the subsequent test and build up to the main exam. That is the best thing which I took from the mock tests as such.
And I also want to like to point out here is that about every competitive exam, it is more about mindset.
Mindset.
So you have to learn to think.
Think.
Think on the day of the exam.
Yes,
most
sir.
People, what they try to do is they do keep doing rote learning year long, and they are not able to think on the day of the exam. And then they lose precious marks and precious opportunities in life.
Yes, sir.
You don't get, not everybody gets not to do neurosurgery in NIMHANS.
NIMHANS.
So that is why, you know, he's such a special boy.
Thank you so
and
much.
And I also want to now ask Aniket a very direct question is, like, how is preparation for NIMHANS different from other exams?
So most of the students today know that NIMHANS being a neuro-oriented institute, we have to prepare more neuro questions than in any other competitive exams conducted all throughout the academic year. What we miss out is, and what I have seen with other people, my colleagues or juniors, is they don't concentrate on the non-neuro part which is happening. If a candidate is just focused on neuro learning, that is not going to happen. Yes, neuro is a main part, but then it is the non-neuro part, because as a neuro institute, everybody is going to study that neuro question. So the competition does not happen in that neuro question. The competition happens in that non-neuro question. So a candidate who is targeting NIMHANS exam has to compulsorily give AIIMS exam, JIPMER exam, PGI exam and NEET as well. So the 12 months of preparation are for non-neuro subject, which is more than enough for NIMHANS exam. And the 3 months after NEET exam that you give, that is the last competitive exam in academic year NIMHANS, that 3 months is solely should be dedicated for neuro related studies, so that you have a very good chance and a high frequency that you are going to get a branch of your choice in that institute. That is what I feel, sir, rather than only concentrating on neuro part.
Now I would like to add here that, you know, it's like this year NIMHANS, they changed the pattern of the exam majorly.
Yes,
so
sir.
It was like 70 questions general and 30 questions for the specialty that you are opting for. And so many future aspirants are not sure what was that paper all about.
Yes, sir.
Will you enlighten them about the real exam that you faced?
Real
exam. And I want to add here that he is rank 5 in neurology also. So he can actually tell about both neurosurgery and neurology.
Yes, sir. When the prospectus came out first time, it was 100 questions, unlike in previous years where it was 150 questions. So we expected that the pattern was changed. But suddenly when the timetable of exam came out, it was totally different than anybody expected it. So 70 questions were from the common subjects, and 30 questions were from the speciality the candidate has opted for the exam. So I had opted only for neurosurgery and neurology exam, but then when neurology was conducted together with common exam, it was a mixture of questions, and then after that 30 questions of neurosurgery came. That is what the pattern this year was.
So what would be your advice to future NIMHANS aspirants? By what I have gathered and what, you know, we repeatedly say is that I'm like, anybody who's preparing for NIMHANS should not be blinded towards neurosciences. In the real exam, you will also have questions on
non-neuro other subjects.
And probably they might be the determinant.
determining exams.
Neurology is it, but the other subjects are also equally important.
Yes.
So what I personally believe is that anybody preparing for NIMHANS should not be blinded
by
only for NIMHANS. And sometimes I see people and they are not even giving other exams.
Exams.
And that is a blunder. So I feel they should give NEET, they should give AIIMS, JIPMER, PGI. Be prepared for the routine subjects. Then in the last 2-3 months, focus on
only on neuro subjects.
That is the kind of thing that actually, you know, gives you the edge.
Edge. Yes. Exactly.
Because what I've seen is, you know, I'm sure, you know, you would add to it with me here, that I've seen some students, they do mistakes in biochemistry questions, yes, and yes. gynae questions, and even in brain, they are solving the toughest questions.
Toughest questions.
But then still, they are not getting top 5 rank.
Yes, yes, yes.
Then it is your waste, yes, because yes. then you can't do the branch of your choice.
Yes, yes. And one special thing about, apart from preparing this, concentrating on non-neuro part, it is not difficult to prepare the non-neuro part, just that you have to get a rank in all the competitive exams. And if you are giving the exams, two things, advantage of giving all competitive exams despite you targeting for NMANS is, first of all, it builds your confidence levels of solving MCQs in the exam itself, in the examiner. And secondly, you get a benchmark to compare yourself for the future competitive exams. If a candidate was not given any exams and directly aiming for the NMANS exam, he would not know head and tail of where am I standing, how much I need to improve in my preparation and everything. So it is a blunder of not focusing on these exams. So that is the two advantages, that you need to focus on non-neuro part exams as well.
So here we have with us Dr. Aniket Shenoy, rank 2 MCH neurosurgery entrance exam. After MBBS, he is directly getting MCH neurosurgery in NMHANS, the premier most institute in the country for neurosurgery. Great achievement. He's a damn student. We are very proud of his achievement.
Thank you, sir.
And we are very proud to say that, you know, we are able to curate courses today for different exams. Like, we have courses separate for MLE exam, for NEET PG, for AIMS we do a special crash course, for PGI we do a special crash course, and for NMHANS as well.
Yes, sir.
So we are very proud of the versatility that our teachers are able to deliver through these different courses, and we are proud of the achievement that our students are able to do and make us proud. It is their results which validate our efforts.
Yes.
We are very proud of his achievement, and now I am going to, you know, go towards the end of this interview by asking him a generic question. I want him to say something motivational to future aspirants.
So future aspirants, there is only one thing for passing in medical profession especially. You do not require intelligence or brilliance. It is only persistence, persistence, persistence. That is the thing which is going to get you wherever you want to be, whichever you branch, whether it is NMANS or any other competitive exam. If you do not have persistence and an IQ beyond 110, that is still not going to get you anywhere in life. Maybe you may pass the entrance exam, but you may not survive the PG life if you are not persistent enough. So I need to tell you that. And even those candidates who had vowed their high efforts on this NMANS but could not get through in any of those fields, I need to tell them that the age limit is still 32 years. There is nothing to stop you from trying again and again and again. If you are not satisfied with what you have, it is not done. So please persist in what you are doing. You will eventually get somewhere in life where you are satisfied with what you have, and you will excel in that. That is what I want to tell.
So beautiful words, and I'm sure, you know, people listening to you should be able to get it. That is just not about intelligence. You know, a lot of people, you know, sometimes, you know, I feel that, you know, some youngsters come to me, they say, sir, I'm smart, I want to study smart. I said, okay, but there are people who are smart also and they're working hard also.
Yes, yes.
How do you intend to beat them? So to beat them, you need to work hard.
Yes, yes,
and,
exactly.
You know, perseverance, to persist despite, you know, losses, that, if that is the key to success. Beautifully put by him. And with this note, we conclude this interview. Wish him all the best. We congratulate him.
Thank you, sir.
And I'm sure India will have a great neurosurgeon in him ahead. And I'm sure a lot of people listening to you today will get inspired to take this beautiful branch ahead.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.